Paul, you're next. Oh, dear.
I am absolutely repulsed by beards. When my friend grew a beard, I changed my phone number so he couldn't contact me.
Right, there we are. Lee.
What's his name?
His name is Ben.
Ben. And what did Ben do?
Well, he used to be a child. Then when he got older, he was a tree surgeon.
Right. So, what is it about beards that you find so repulsive?
Well, it's just... Like, the idea of touching a beard is horrible, and it can't be hygienic. I mean, there must be dirt
well,
in it.
Look to your left. I think you'd have to go a long way to find a better, more respectfully kept beard than David Mitchell's.
But David Mitchell can afford to have a beard cleaning person. The average beard person, they don't even wash it, do they? It's all dirty, bits of egg in there and all sorts.
You would obviously never consider a beard yourself, then, obviously.
No, no, I...
But on a windy day, surely those bits of hair around the side of your head are going to go over your face, because that's quite long hair you've got there.
But they're all lovely and soft.
Well...
Whereas when a beard is all scratchy and thick hair.
I imagine David's beard isn't scratchy. I imagine David's beard is comforting, soft and welcoming. And I invite you now... to enjoy David's beard.
I mean, strictly speaking, it's not your invitation to give.
But you would be doing a great service to Paul.
No, I would be honoured were Paul
please.
To fondle my face.
Paul, knock yourself out.
Leave it to me to invite him.
Well,
go ahead if it would give you pleasure.
It does not give me pleasure, that's the whole point. I hate it. But, you know...
Oh, he's doing it, he's doing it. He's doing it.
If this is going to make you throw up, we can both do without that footage on YouTube.
Did you tell your friend why you changed your number?
No, well, what happened is he used to have a smooth face, and then he grew and it was a massive beard and it was all really long and really unkempt, you know, like all long and then I just couldn't deal with it.
And you've never seen or heard from him since?
Well, I can't because he hasn't got my number. He can't contact me.
When was this, Paul? How long ago?
2010.
Oh, sorry, I think you say years.
2010 years after the birth of Christ.
I mean, you picked a good example. If you saw an image of Jesus Christ, would you have problems looking at it because of the beard? Or does it have to be a friend that's
well,
in your personal space?
I mean, Jesus isn't my friend in that way.
He is, Paul.
Yes.
And he's yours too. But not yours, Lee. All right, so what's it going to be, Lee? Is it true or is it a lie?
What do we think?
True. Absolutely. Every word of it.
It's a lie. It's got to be a lie.
You've done the opposite again. OK, so you're saying it's a lie, you're saying it's
true.
I'm going to go for true.
You're going to say it's true?
Yeah.
OK, Paul Foote, was that true or was it a lie?
It is... True.